WinCC version 8 step-by-step. Create a report layout.
We're going to start in WinCC Explorer. I'll click on Report Designer and expand that and just double-click on Layouts. The Layout Editor opens and it looks a lot like Graphics Designer. We have color palettes and different property palettes, and we also have an object library with different types of objects. We also have different sheets for the reports. We have a cover sheet, a reports content, and a last page. And then we also have two modes. They call them parts, dynamic part and static part. So first, we're going to go to the static part and we're going to do the cover sheet. And we're just going to do a quick cover sheet for this. So I will highlight my project name and pull it out. And then I can just use my font pull down to give it a bigger font. And then if we want to change other properties, we can just right click properties, set my alignment. And I can also give it different colors if I want. And then other than the project name, maybe we want the time that the report was run. So on my object palette, I'll take a static text. Just add some label. And again, I can go to properties here and I could set my font here. And then here under system objects, I'll just take the date time object. Pull it out. And we also have the eyedroppers, so I can copy the properties and paste them into here. And then for our cover page, maybe we want a screenshot of the WinCC runtime screen. So we'll go under dynamic objects, and the hard copy object is what we want to use, but we're going to have to be in the dynamic mode. And so we'll pull this out and just size it. And then we'll double click and on connect, the area selection allows me to define what areas of the screen that we would like to copy. So we can do X, Y, width and heights coordinates, or we can just do current window. So I'll do hard copy of the current window and just click OK. And we'll save. So we're going to give this a name and let's just call this Shift Report. We'll be adding more stuff to it. Notice how we have underscore ENU, that is a language designator. So make sure you leave that part intact. It will save it in the ENU folder and just click save. I'm going to now go to the reports contents page and we're gonna add some stuff to the header. So we're gonna add the project name and layout name. And in order to do this, we need to be in the static mode. And at the top of the header, I'll put the project name. Set my font property. And then I'll also put a page number here. And then at the bottom, we'll put our layout. Also set our font there. And I'll put maybe a date and time down here. So next I want to put process information, say from alarm logging and tag logging. We'll go to the Runtime Documentation tab, and we need to be in the dynamic mode. These are dynamic objects. I'll go under Alarm Logging, and we have two things here, Archive Report and Message Report. Message Report are active alarms. Archive Report are archived messages. So I'll choose a message. These controls are self-paginating. They're going to grow to fit the data, so you don't have to make them big like this. We can just do say one line, and then we'll double click to get to the properties. And on the connect tab, I'll go into selection. So here we can select the blocks that we want, and I will just put message text there. We'll just click OK. Next, we'll do an archive report, and I'll do the same thing here. I'll double click. And maybe put duration there. Click OK. So we'll do the online trend control here. And we're just going to pull this out. It's going to graphically generate basically a trend screen based on what we do. And again, I'll double click. And on the properties, you can see this is just like a regular trend control. So we will do our red, green, and blue color strengths. So for red, I'll choose a red color and then link it to our red color strength archive. And then for green, we'll do the same thing. Choose a tag name here. We'll hit apply. And then we'll go look at our value axes. And we'll just set this 0 to 100. And then on our time axes, this is how much time the window represents. We'll just set this for 20 minutes. Then we'll just click OK. Close our properties and hit save. Now also notice when you change modes, some of the controls will disappear. That's okay. They're only visible in the relevant mode that they're in. So lastly, we want to put some text labels on these objects. So I will find my static text and just say this is my active alarms. I can just duplicate this. This is my archives. So maybe give it a little bit different color. And just do trends. And then we'll save.